Hi, I'm Dan, and I'm Finn, Drink Editor in TN2, and today I'm going to be talking to you about honey. So, how did I really get into honey? I was in France over the summer, and I attended a honey tasting in the zoo, as you do. And from what I can understand, there's an awful lot of corruption in the industry, and there's an awful lot of differences of taste depending on where the honey came from. So, when I came home, I really wanted to see what was behind a real Irish local honey. As a pharmacy student, I already knew that honey had a lot of medicinal properties. It's really good for hay fever, sealing a dry cough. Apparently, rumour has it that Kate Middleton is a big fan of bee venom cream. Bee venom is exactly what causes a sting when you get stung by a bee. Who thought a princess would want to get stung in the face by themselves? But enough about France and the UK. What about Ireland? Me and a few of the food and drink team at TN2 went out to visit a local beekeeper in Camtee to see what it was all about. Wayne O'Connor, the king bee of the Irish honey industry, set us a honey trap and lured us in.
See if you can find the queen.
Yeah. With bee suits, smoke machines, and junior set woodwork, Wayne shows us what it's like to make a local Irish honey. And apparently all you need is junior cert woodwork skills to make your own hustling and bustling bee house of your own.
But I mean, the boxes are easy enough.
Yeah,
there's no reason why anybody with junior cert woodwork skills.
Or maybe it's just an advent why you feel pushed in the right direction by buying an introductory course of beekeeping like our Wayne did. Or maybe just an interest in entomology.
First experience, not always great.
Oh, that's very interested.
At the moment, there's probably about 20,000-30,000 bees in here.
Pretty strong.
Strong. Stronger than the dog. Like, come on. So, porridge, toast, or base it on your Sunday roast. Consider the Lehaunstown honey.